So I finally got over my cold yesterday, but it took an additional day to get my energy levels back up. But now I'm ready to get back to finally making videos. I had planned on doing a video response to Sandman regarding the whole Monks of MGTOW issue, but I feel now that such a video wouldn't be as relevant since so much time has passed, and it would feel like I'm dragging the issue back into the spotlight after most people have moved on. But after speaking to I Am Serious in a hangout yesterday, I've decided that while I'm not going to do a direct response, I will look at the larger issues involved and offer my perspective on the matters by drawing parallels to another community of men. I've heard it said that men won't defend other men, won't stand up for other men, and certainly won't risk their lives for other men. Those who say this have never served in the military, particularly the Army or Marines, during an active campaign. Now, I can imagine guys from the Air Force or Navy that have only fired a weapon during a marksmanship qualification not understanding or experiencing this male bond. But for those of you who've served in Iraq or Afghanistan recently, you should know what I'm talking about. For those that don't, or have only seen Hollywood movies, I highly recommend a documentary called Restrepo about an army unit stationed in the worst part of Afghanistan filmed over an entire year. None of the footage was staged, there are no actors, it's the real deal. People actually die over the course of the documentary. But you can see the bonds and the brotherhood that's formed. These men defended each other, they stood up for each other, and they risked their lives for each other. This documentary is available on Netflix, or you can see it on YouTube, but the quality is subpar. I'll provide a link to the YouTube version in the description, but be aware that the audio is really quiet, and it's worth checking out on Netflix if you have it. In the military, there's a culture of leaving no man behind. Now, it's been tainted because the military is still run by the government, and thus by gynocentrism and feminism. Men in the military get routinely bent over the couch and fucked by their ex-wives, and women do get promoted over men because of gender quotas. But as I said in my video about office cunts, women don't enjoy dangerous jobs. So when it comes to doing the primary job of the military, which is combat, you won't find many women around. Even within the Israeli Defense Force, which has a female draft, 95.7% of combat troops are male. Terrence Pop did a video about women in the military called Can't Cut the Mustard, which I'll link to. But I'm not here to talk about women, I'm here to talk about men. So I want to draw some parallels from the military culture in MGTOW. When you talk to veterans, there is a bond and a respect for one another, even though these veterans come from different backgrounds and served in different wars. However, there is a sense of elitism within the ranks of veterans. Some of the older veterans feel that younger vets had it easier compared to them due to more advanced technology, such as armor and things like drones. Likewise, younger vets can point to the older vets and proudly proclaim that they volunteered to serve in the military, while the older vets were drafted against their will. How much more worthy of respect is the man that walks willingly into danger than the man that must have a gun pointed at his head to do so after all? I can see this kind of elitism between some groups of MGTOW. There are some MGTOW that don't want anything to do with women, and accuse MGTOW that choose to date or have short-term relationships of being pickup artists or fake MGTOW. Meanwhile, the MGTOW that date accuse those who reject women of being beta males, TFL, or cowards. I think these divisions are as stupid as older vets and younger vets arguing about who's the better veteran. One can argue about degrees or levels, but this isn't a martial arts dojo. There are no ranks or leaders, no badges or titles. If we simply have a respect for people's individual concept of self-actualization, it's obvious how ridiculous it is to compare people's sex lives. This isn't a community of celibacy like NOFAP. We're not joining the Catholic priesthood. We're rejecting marriage and gynocentrism. That doesn't mean we can't get our dicks moisturized once in a while. In these arguments between these two groups of MGTOW, there are men being harmed in the crossfire. Turning back to veterans for another moment, although older and younger veterans may argue and disagree about a lot of things, they all have nothing but compassion and empathy for the men who've been wounded or disfigured by war. You'll see vets making fun of the guys who made PowerPoints in the Air Force, but they'll never make fun of a man who's lost his legs in an IED explosion or suffered from third-degree burns from a shape charge. This is what I've unfortunately seen in MGTOW, where men who've suffered in divorce are being unfairly targeted. I understand the desire to defend oneself against slander and elitism, but the danger of being indirect about that defense is that men who aren't even part of the dispute become targeted. Now, in Sandman's video MGTOW Monk, some regrettable statements were made, and I'm not going to get into them because Razorblade Candy already did an excellent job of picking that video apart. If you are interested, I'll provide a link in the description to the video from RBK. I agree with all the criticisms raised in that video, although I don't think Sandman was freebasing crack. Many have seen the MGTOW Monks video, but may have missed Sandman's response in a video called Are Gay Men Lucky? They may have missed this response because the title doesn't suggest that it's a response to the MGTOW Monks criticism, but I'll provide a link in the description with a timecode that will skip the talk about gay men and get right to Sandman's response in the latter part of the video. In this response, Sandman says he wasn't talking about men who don't date being cowards, but men who've had trouble moving past the emotional pain they've experienced and withdraw from society, especially women. Sandman advocates processing and moving past the pain, facing your feelings and living a better life. He apologizes for calling men cowards for struggling with their feelings at the 9:47 mark. I'll provide a link with the time code in the description as well. This is very similar to the stages of loss and grief. I'll provide a link in the description to an article regarding this, and I'm sure this has been covered before, but here's a quick recap of the five stages. 1. Denial and isolation. 2. Anger. 3. Bargaining. 4. Depression. 5. Acceptance. Sandman was apparently trying to help men who are stuck on one of the first four stages in order to help them move on to the fifth stage, which is acceptance. Now, I think he did this in a clumsy way and obviously put his foot in his mouth when he called these men cowards or accused them of wallowing in their filth and misery. If the intent of his video was to help these men get to the acceptance stage, then using shaming language is counterproductive. A man suffering from isolationism, anger, or depression will only isolate themselves further and become more angry and depressed when shaming language is used to quote-unquote motivate them to move on. If you truly want to help these men, you have to get down to their level, understand them, and walk alongside them. However, rather than just bag on Sandman's clumsy approach, I want to shine a spotlight on an example of the right way to help these men, which is an ongoing video series by Dark Knight regarding transcendence. Before I got sick, I made a 15-minute abridged version of his series for this video, with Dark Knight's permission, of course. But while I was sick, he released two more videos in the series, so now it's already outdated. Rather than include the montage, I'll just provide links in the description to the 7 videos in the series that have been released by Dark Knight at the time of this recording. If you're a man who's been damaged, and you're stuck in the isolation, anger, bargaining, or depression stages, and you want some compassionate guidance to help you move forward, I can't recommend Dark Knight's videos enough. You really feel the love and compassion in his voice, and you can tell that he cares about you and wants to help you because he's right there with you. Your struggles are his struggles because he's been there and he understands you. We need to get back to the valuable work of improving men's lives with knowledge and understanding. There are hurt and wounded men out there that need us. Our gynocentric culture has betrayed them, and the rest of the manosphere is too busy fighting feminism to help them. Fighting feminism, traditionalism, and gynocentrism are important, but when a soldier sees a wounded brother, their first priority is to get him to safety. That is how you defeat gynocentrism, with brotherhood.